We're here at the Web 2.0 Summit here in San Francisco, California, and with me I have the CEO and CTO of Singly. How's it going, guys?
Good.
Great.
So what is Singly? What problem do you solve?
So Singly is a company that hosts your personal data. We allow you to get everything that you create or emanate digitally back together in a place that you can secure it, see it, share it in different ways. What it solves really is a developer problem today, which is it's hard to build applications that pull multiple services together. What it solves in the long run is really empowering people with their data to do more things with it.
So this whole discussion at the Web 2.0 Summit this year, a lot of it's in the data frame, as they say. And part of that is really this idea of data ownership, that people have to step up in some way and try to hold on to that. How does that functionally work for someone with Singly?
So you would create a Singly account. Now, the stuff that we do is open source, which we can also talk about. But the Singly account, you come in and you authorize your services, and it pulls in a copy of your data. And then there's applications that you can actually install and run on top of your data, which basically allow you to use it in different ways, mash it up, share it in different ways. There's also an API. So you can imagine in the very near future where we're heading is ways that third-party applications can pull your data to that experience and make it richer based on the repository that you've generated with your account.
Cool. So we've got a business purpose, you've got the reason for developers to care, and then we've got how it comes home to the consumer. And let's talk about tech strategy a little bit. You've got the CTO here. It's a great resource. Why go open source? What sort of outcomes do you see coming out of that?
Well, since the problem that we're trying to solve is to open up this ecosystem and enable, you know, more data to be shared in more ways with more consent and control by the people who own it, there will be no logic in the platform being a closed one. We want it to be used as widely as possible. We want people to trust it and to be able to look at the code. And we want people who don't necessarily want Singly to host their personal data to be able to do it elsewhere. The important thing to us is to put people back at the center of that whole system and to give them as many ways to do that as we can.
So do you see people doing that and taking the software and installing it elsewhere? Or what are the outcomes here?
Some adventurous souls are doing that today.
Okay.
It's not an easy matter at this point, because it's still under very active development. But you get to see some of what they're able to do with that platform, the talk we're about to give this afternoon.
Great. And can you find the code at github.com/singly?
Yeah, it's linked off of singly.com.
Okay.
It's easy to find.
All right, so last question. I know you're about to go up there pretty soon. What are some of the early effects so far of Singly's launch? You've gotten uptake from the coding community, you've gotten some uptake from the developing community. There's some crossover there, obviously. What's been the response?
We've started to see signups on our homepage. We're going to start letting those folks on an invite basis come in. And just in the last week, we've been able to actually create a ton of value, just 30-minute sessions, lots of applications. We expect the people we let in to do the same. The experience will get richer and richer as you have a Singly account and as you start as a developer enriching that and sharing that to other people.
Great. So, again, that's Singly. So it's sing and then .ly?
No, we actually have singly.com now.
Singly.com.
Yeah.
I'm behind the times in your URL.
Yeah.
Well, that's why I'm glad I asked.
Yeah, thanks.
All right, so there you go. The CTO and CEO of Singly. You can check their site online. And if you're a developer, there's obviously some other tools to check out as well.